Hello for Monday, July 23rd, and no market charts today because it's a weekend. So I'll go to stocktiger.net, upper right-hand corner, take a look at the newsletter there. We've got loads of charts, like 70 charts. Mark was up last week, most of the week until Friday it dipped. It may continue dipping again this week as well. There's lots of earnings, so that could alter things as well. ALNY, pharmaceutical first. You can see it ran up big time for that $13 up to $20. Been flagging for 4 days. This could swing on the upside or could be on the downside. If it goes on the downside and you short it, I think not aggressively. In other words, keep your stops short. It could pull down, like say, 16 or 17 and get some traction right there. But I think it's more likely at least they'll try it on the upside to see if it can go further or not, above 1930 or 1950, and of course, especially if it has some good volume behind it. Next up, we've got BWS on a flag as well, this time over about 1350 to 1360. 1380 was its previous high. It's had low volume since then. It's only 293,000 shares. So look for a break on good volume. Now, it may pull down as low as the 20-day. And if it goes down there and holds it, that could be a buy too. And then if it can't break out of the flag, you can trade it back up to the top of the flag if that's where it goes. Okay, how about Dole? Dole Foods did well on Friday, must have reported good earnings. You can see they ran up. So on a pullback, if it holds above that 200-day, which is at 962, that might be an opportunity to get in for a really short-term trade. Could go as high as that 1125 again. I would say back over that 11 or the 1025 would be an area to watch for a shorter-term trade. ED over about $64. That's as high as it went. 63. Where'd it close at? 63.77. Got as high as 64. So we'll move it back over 64. Looks like pretty good setup and also had good volume on Friday. GDI is up next over about 53.70. Then that 55.40, that was its high of the day. Let's just double check that. Yeah, 54.48, so let's say 54.50 would be the line as well. It ran up above the 50-day into that resistance on the left and then pulled back. So maybe next time. It had pretty good volume. Of course, it did have big sell-off volume as well. It's trying to make up for that. Maybe it can't break out of range, but it can on good volume. It could move some more. LL over 34.70. Pretty good pattern. Just been consolidating. Friday's down day in the market. Wasn't down on this one. It stayed pretty nice. Looks like it may be moving higher. And we have NTAP over about $31. It did run into the 50-day, pulled back a little bit. It may try and run over it once again. So first, the 31, or let's say $32, sorry, over 32, especially with good volume. Do note that the Williams indicator has gone back above the 80 line. So that's how we start off this Monday. Hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. We will send tweets out before the market opens and during the day as well, so please watch for them. Otherwise, we'll be back again tomorrow. Some new ideas in Market Wrap. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.